You've been hearing a lot about Azure Arc enabled data services, and there were some great announcements at Microsoft Build. In this episode, learn all about the new jumpstart scenarios, which can help you if you're just getting started or going into production. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Lior from the Azure Arc Jumpstart team. Lior, thanks so much for coming again on the show. I think you're becoming a regular.
Yes, I'm definitely becoming a regular. It's always great to come back, Anna. Thanks for inviting me.
It's always great to have you on. And today, we're going to be talking about Azure Arc-enabled data services, specifically the jumpstart scenarios, and a lot of the updates that are happening in that space. But for viewers who might not be familiar with Azure Arc enabled data services, I thought it might be great if you could give like the highest level overview of what that is.
Of course. So, Azure Arc in general is a set of technologies, a set of services that are designed to interact with IT assets that are deployed outside of Azure. Now, there are basically two ways of going by and talking about this, which is, one, there are the assets that are already deployed outside of Azure and we're bringing them into Azure, or the assets that we are deploying to the outside world based on Kubernetes clusters. And Azure Arc-enabled data services is one of those hero scenarios that we have for deploying data services like SQL Managed Instance and PostgreSQL on top of Kubernetes clusters that are also Arc-enabled, but also deployed outside of Azure physically. So Azure Arc-enabled data services, like I mentioned, it covers SQL Managed Instance, which we're going to focus a lot about today, and also PostgreSQL. So those are the two services that are allowing us to deploy that in a managed fashion. So you're getting those managed services outside of Azure.
Love it. That's a great overview and definitely explains the value prop. So then if we switch gears and say, okay, we know what Azure Arc-enabled data services is, what is this jumpstart thing and why do people need it?
Yeah, so we talked about it before that the jumpstart is really just kind of became the de facto standard when it comes to the how the community is interacting with Azure Arc and how do you, you know, how they can go by and learn about Azure Arc. So the Azure Arc jumpstart that, you know, the website that I'm showing you right now is really just kind of the gateway for everything that is Azure Arc. And the way that we like to think about this is that we are providing a zero to hero experience when it comes to Azure Arc. Everything is based on scenarios and automated scenarios and a lot of details that will show you how to go by and deploy these services or interact with these Azure Arc services in, like I said, in an automated fashion. And we're covering all the Azure Arc technologies. And today we're here to talk about the new Azure Arc enabled data services scenarios.
Okay, awesome. This sounds like a great thing, especially if you're just getting started, but even if you're going into production, maybe, I'm assuming. So take us through, what are some of these new scenarios that you all have released?
Yeah, for sure. So, in Build a few weeks back, right? I think it was 3 weeks ago, something like that, time flybys. We announced new capabilities for Azure Arc-enabled SQL Managed Instance. Those capabilities are really focusing on the production-grade nuances that we have. So things like disaster recovery and upgradability and Active Directory authentication and all that jazz. So, because the Jumpstart team is working very closely with all the Azure Arc product groups, we decided to come up with a new batch of scenarios that are going to cover those production-grade capabilities. So today, that's what I want to show you. So in the Azure Arc Jumpstart, what I'm going to do, I'm going to go into Jumpstart scenarios, and I'll scroll to Azure Arc-enabled data services. This is where you're going to find all the data services scenarios. And generally speaking, the Azure Arc Jumpstart is splitting into two types of scenarios. We have bootstrap scenarios, which are designed to bootstrap the infrastructure and the environment, the Kubernetes clusters, and all the automations of the data services around that. And as you can see, there is a breadth of Kubernetes flavors that we support. And there's also the unified operation scenarios or day two scenarios. These are the scenarios that are really showing the value proposition of Azure Arc and specifically with Azure Arc enabled data services. So what I want to show you today is few of the unified operations use cases that we developed for supporting those production grade capabilities. So in this May-June release, right, as you know, Anna, we're working in 1 month sprints. In this release, we released few new scenarios and update also the existing scenarios that we have, all to support this production grade, you know, state of mind. So the first scenario that I want to show you is the SQL managed instance availability group, right? Availability groups has been there for a while now, and it's a familiar concept for everyone that is in the SQL space. And Azure Arc enabled SQL managed instance is no different. So in this scenario, what you will see is you will get an automated flow for showing how you are deploying SQL managed instance with availability groups. And we also provide you with the guidelines on how to do the failover, how to actually test that the availability group is replicating and everything is operational. So as you can see, again, this is just kind of the spirit of the jumpstart. No detail is too small, and the level of screenshots, the explanations, everything is there just to make sure that you understand all the small nuances as you are going through the scenario. So that's the first one, availability groups for a SQL managed instance. So I just wanted to show you that. That's an updated scenario. It's been there for a while, but we wanted to just do a bit of refresh. The second scenario that I want to show you is a big one. So as you know, Azure Arc enabled SQL managed instance, now we are supporting Active Directory authentication. We support Active Directory authentication with either custom managed deployed keys or keystab or system managed. So the first scenario that we wanted to release around the Active Directory support with SQL managed instance is the customer managed keytab. And as you can see, this is again the same spirit. And what you will get out of this scenario, and we explain all the automation flow and everything that is happening, right? But at the end of the day, it's a single click deployment. What you will get out of this scenario is you will get an AKS cluster, right? To just kind of demonstrate a Kubernetes environment. On that AKS cluster, you will get a full-blown SQL managed instance deploy, either in HA fashion or not, right? Business critical is something that we announced again at build, and all our scenario supports business critical. But more importantly, what you will get out of this scenario is also an Active Directory infrastructure, right? Spin up for you. Everything is automatic, right? So what you will get is basically the integration between SQL, and I'll scroll all the way down, just kind of show you how it looks like. What you will get is basically the end-to-end integration with Active Directory. So the database that is deployed, right, in this scenario is already authenticated against that Active Directory infrastructure. And again, you don't need to spin up your own Active Directory. You don't need to use your own Active Directory infrastructure. We just do that for you in an ephemeral fashion. So this was the Active Directory authentication. Another scenario is the disaster recovery. That's another new scenario that we developed. And something that our readers and our users asking us to do, and we're starting to incorporate that, is also including this very, you know, graphical design architecture diagrams to just kind of explain what is going on in the scenario. This scenario is focusing on disaster recovery for SQL managed instance. Again, basically a new capability that that we're starting to light up with SQL managed instance. And what you will get out of this scenario is you're basically going to get two AKS clusters, like full-blown Kubernetes infrastructure, that will show you how to failover and how to do a DR scenario, full HA DR scenario between those Kubernetes clusters. And again, we're providing you with all the guidelines and everything. So by the end of this scenario, the user will be able to actually experience the failover, just kind of see how SQL managed instance, Azure Arc enabled SQL managed instance, is acting in a multi-Kubernetes environment. So pretty cool scenario. And the last one that I want to show you as part of this batch is the migrate to Azure Arc enabled SQL managed instance. You know, and a migration is one of the biggest use cases when it comes to SQL managed instance. People that are looking for Azure SQL, Azure Arc enabled SQL managed instance are really in that space of, hey, I have SQL instances on premises, but I can't move them to the cloud, but I am looking to modernize, right? Mm-hmm. So the way that we are doing this is basically by providing SQL managed instance or Azure Arc enabled SQL managed instance on their Kubernetes clusters. And that scenario that you're seeing right here will basically show an automated flow on how to take SQL that is on premises and migrate the databases into SQL managed instance that is Arc enabled and deployed on a Kubernetes cluster for the customer environment. So that's really that scenario. And this is the the last one that I wanted to show you. So as you can see, four scenarios that are really just kind of part of that batch that shows this enterprise-grade capabilities of the new things that are coming with SQL managed instance.
Yeah, I mean, Lira, this is really awesome to see. And it's great to see how much your team is really putting out there so folks can get started with this more easily, because it can be maybe a little bit overwhelming if you haven't worked with Kubernetes to get started with these things. And all the automation behind it is really awesome. I wanted to clarify one of the things that you mentioned earlier before we close, and that was, you know, these are great scenarios. And of course, I can use them for learning. Do you see customers kind of using this and refactoring it a little bit and using it for their production workloads? Or how do you kind of see this being used with customers?
Yeah, it's a great question, Anna. Definitely 100% we are seeing this. And the way that we are seeing this happening is basically by taking the code that we are providing as part of these scenarios. And because this is an open source community-driven project, right, they can rip out the code and they're actually using that for their own automations as part of their CI pipelines and deployments and all that. So that's, you know, that's one way for people to use that. And another way for people using the Jumpstart in general, and specifically with what we called RBox, is basically this is becoming the reference implementation for cloud adoption framework landing zones for Azure Arc. So as of today, we have one landing zone accelerator for servers and another one for Kubernetes. And you know, you can expect us releasing data services landing zone accelerator pretty soon with a new flavor of RBox, which will also be able, a customer or a user will be able to take that code and expand it to their production environment.
Cool. I love that. And I love the little teaser. So we'll have to stay tuned and have you back on once there's something in that space. Sure. But we'll have our viewers stay tuned. Lira, thanks so much for joining us on the show today. To our viewers, if you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like. Leave us a comment and let us know what you're doing with the Azure Arc Jumpstart scenarios, which scenario you're using today. And check the description for links to learn more. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.